butcher knife and tenderly stabbed two children and they fell to their death. And people were shocked and some people screamed during the performance and two-thirds of the audience left. And a friend of mine from Paris, Benedict Pell, was there and she said, you know, Bob, I said, I can't believe, Benedict, that almost everyone in the audience left. She said, you know, Bob, this is a very good sign. The city of Hamburg has seen more premieres of my work than have been seen in New York City, where I live. It's given me a home. In addition to presenting works of mine they've created, I've taken the risk to produce the work. 1976, the Schauspiel House was a co-producer of Einstein on the Beach. In order to present the work in my own country, in the Metropolitan Opera, I went to the Metropolitan Opera, and I gave for the production costs. One of the most important works that I showed here was Parsifal. I did two Parsifals. I did Wagner's Parsifal and I did my own with Tancred d'Ors. With the young American artist Christopher Knowles. He played for 1 year in the repertory, Parsifal. And looking back on all the works, I think that to me it's one of the most impressive to see this honesty, this integrity of this man on stage. A boy who was unable to tell a lie. A boy who had no formal education. A young man who had been locked up and institutionalized in the United States, thought to be not educable, was given a chance to perform here at the Thalia Theater with professional actors in repertory for a year. Benjamin Hendricks, theater critic at that time, wrote an article at the end of the year saying, for him, the most impressive performance of the season was the work of Christopher Knowles. So I'll always be grateful to this beautiful city for the support of my work, for giving me a home. When I was making Time Rocker with Lou Reed here, had a workshop and it was in June, early June, and it was raining and sleeting and cold, miserable weather. And a reporter said, Mr. Reed, why do you like Hamburg? He says, because I like the weather.
Which have just guided you, and it has guided you. I hope most of you will come to our book, and I will then say a little bit more about Bob Wilson. I think today and here, it is the hour of the honor of Bob, and perhaps later I will make some animals about him. I try at least. Yes. Then we have some distance from honor. Honor is something special. Yes, when I, my personal, perhaps some personal words to Bob, I met him when I tried to arrange the Paul Tech show here in Hamburg, which was a very important show, and he is the president of the estate, and so I wanted to get hold of him. To get hold of Bob Wilson is not absolutely Wilson, it's nearly impossible Wilson, yes. And so it was Ben Garus, my friend, and his friend, who said to him, come on, visit the Falckenberg collection. A lot of discussions with all his teams. I think there were 2 days with everything this way or that way. And then it was decided, yes, 20 minutes to go there, 20 minutes to go back, and then a time slot of 20 minutes for the show. Yes. And, okay, we went there, and he stood before the first picture, and he watched. He just watched. And you see, I have a little bit different temper than yes, I had needed 35 minutes to watch the first picture, and I couldn't say anything. It was a deaf man glance. Yes. Anyhow, we went to the second picture. It took again 30 minutes. And then I said, Bob, you are a little bit different. Please allow me. I go to the office and lie down a little bit and sleep. And if you are ready, please come back. And indeed, it took 3.5 hours until Bob came back. And that was a time slot of 20 minutes, by the way. And he said, it's a wonderful exhibition. It's a wonderful collection. And then I dared to ask him, would he perhaps lend me some works of Paul Tech? And he said yes. That was the beginning of a wonderful relation, which led us to Waterville and everything. I wanted to say the slowness, I don't want to take too much time for my little speech, the slowness brings me to honoring a company. I think a company who has deserved to be thanked and honored here, that is the company Mont Blanc. You know, the Mont Blanc with the pen holder, the principle is to have much slowness, not get rid of all the hurry of the life. And Mont Blanc is one of the big supporters of the Kunsthalle since years. And so it's very nice that we are here. And when Bob, whose organization, I don't know whether you finished your administrative studies, but anyhow, he has ideas until the last moment, last minute's ideas, I would call them. And so he had the idea to have a screen which is 2.60 meters, and so, and naturally very, very expensive. And I said, no, I'm exhausted. And then he asked Mont Blanc. And that was wonderful. Mont Blanc sponsored this money. And so you will see tonight this big screen. And there are one man and one company together having a lot of honor for slowness. So thank you.